Welcome to a midweek Space Engineers short tutorial. This is an impromptu one as we move towards the weekend and my laser antenna tutorial. This one is all about the vanilla version of Space Engineers, or rather the retail version. As you can see, I've got mine, I've got all the DLC, and a few things I wanted to talk about. One, we have, as of the last update, the Community Crossplay update, mods. And mods need this, experimental mode. You also need to make sure that you accept this, the workshop agreement between us and mod.io. When you have experimental mode active, make sure you press OK by pressing X, and you'll know you've got experimental mode because you'll see it on the top right hand corner. I've explained in the past how to put mods on a game, but I'm going to do it for the vanilla version of Space Engineers so that everybody's on the same page and people can just look at this very last tutorial in this list and say, ah, that's where it is. We're going to hit load game. We're going to go to my Pertum main mod test save, and we're going to press X. Then we're going to make sure that I'm in survival, because I want to show you something about mods and survival. And then we want to press the three lines to open up the mod menu. There it is in all its glory. Now, if you press the three lines again, you will see the mod menu. Here you can subscribe to the mods you want. Once you're done, press back. If they don't appear on the left hand side, press the Y button. It will refresh the mod list. See, today I want to pop on mods. So how do we get mods over here? Well, it's really easy. I could activate all the mods. I can activate some mods, but I'm going to do them one at a time. I want the Azimuth Remastered, the Cult Command Console Pack, the Megamod Pack, the Admiral Suite, some animated consoles. Now remember, the more mods you put on, the longer Space Engineers will take to load. The Small Ship Megamod Pack, the Vanilla Mod Pack, and the Defense Shield Wall. For now. So once you've got all of those on the right hand side, press X. Press X once more, and you'll go back to the load game menu. Then make sure you're on your saved game and hit load. Now, a quick word, if your game crashes while you have mods enabled, it is not Space Engineers. It potentially is the mod itself. You'll need to remove mods one by one, or remove them all and then add a mod until your game no longer crashes. Keen Software House cannot be held responsible for third-party installed content crashing the game. This is what mods can do. They will or can cause Space Engineers become unstable, especially if you're playing around with speed mods which break the speed limit. So here we are on my Pertum test planet, and we'll bring up admin menu. Now, I'm just going to briefly do this, and what we have here is my test. It has not been fully built yet. It's still in progress because this is a copy of my actual survival. You'll notice I'm starting to lose oxygen in this area because it's cold at night. But that is the rotary airlock. That's a mod. That's one of my favourite mods. And when you're playing survival, mods are not going to show up if you have creative mode tools enabled. If you turn creative mode tools off, then you will see that as you press your build menu and you move across using the right trigger, the first page will pop up, modded 1, then modded 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If you have a USB keyboard and plug it in, tap the G key, and regardless of whether or not you have creative mode tools enabled, which I'm just re-enabling to show you the change in the mod menu, you'll notice now mods don't show up. But if you've got a keyboard and you press the G key, mods will appear regardless of the mode or regardless of whether or not you've got creative mode tools on. So it's a bit dark at the moment. Hold down right bumper. Why? And we're going to set the time of day. Just push forward until the sun comes up. Turn our light off. And there it is. These are the self-repair lightning rods that protect my HQ from being blasted into smithereens. That's my solar panel array, which I was playing around with. It does not track the sun because on solo and hosted Space Engineers multiplayer games, you can't have scripts running that run on the client side. Microsoft will not allow it due to issues. It's a long, complicated issue that if Keen can find a way around, or Keen can somehow do something, they will. But the chances are of us getting certain scripts like solar tracking, they'd need to be built into the main game. Like we have scripts already, they're just not the scripts that you can download from other people. And many times you have to modify those scripts in the game itself, and that's where Microsoft has an issue. Dedicated servers can run server-side scripts, but that's about it. So, yes, mod. There it is, the rotary airlock. In all its glory. So if you want to build and you want to test mods, my suggestion is just open up a creative version of your save, make a copy of it, change the mode. But if you don't want to do that, you have creative mode tools on, you won't see the mod list. Turn it off briefly and go to your build menu, find the thing like the rotary airlock that you want, or the shield wall, and because I'm carrying some steel plates, I can place the first component of the rotary airlock down. So place your first component, come out of that, hold down RBY, creative mode tools, push right on the D-pad, bring up your welder, and weld your rotary airlock free of charge into life. Yeah, that is a mod. There are many mods, and more being added and worked on. Azimuth have an absolute fortune of mods. And that's how mods work in survival. They will not show up in this menu until you turn those creative mode tools off. And your mod menu should pop up. If your mod menu is not popping up, I'm not sure what's wrong. Unless somehow, if you don't have experimental mode, you won't see mods. You need experimental mode on to be able to run mods. And that's really it for mods. The chunky rover. Hopefully it'll be useful to somebody You have to excuse me taking slight pauses. I still have to recover my breath now and then. This is just a side effect of the virus. Enjoy these mods and leave a comment. Hopefully this gets you going. As I said, if the mod menu's not appearing and you have got experimental mode on and you're pretty sure you're not running creative mode tools, open up a creative save, add a ton of mods to a creative save, then play that and see if they appear. If you own a USB keyboard, drop that in, press the G key, see if mods are appearing in that menu. That's all for now. Until the next one, there are different videos coming and they will appear as and when. They're not really on any schedule. I try to do tutorials sort of Saturdays, maybe Sunday. And this video was a special one because I'd seen a lot of people on the Xbox Space Engineers group. I'll leave the link to that group in the description. Ask about why their mods weren't appearing, even though they got mods in Creative. And I've also seen a couple of comments on my other videos about this. So, hopefully it helps. And I will catch you in the next one. Stay safe, take care, wear a mask. You definitely don't want to go through what I went through. Have fun. Bye for now.